In the past year, I made quite a lot of videos about how to run WebGL on web browser, which allows you to run intense 3D graphics using GPU. The result is so great, and it gives me an idea if we can run this project so smoothly. How about we run an actual game engine? What will it be? In this video, I will show you how to run Unreal Engine 4 project with HTML5 and how it performs on web browsers. Ready? Let's check it out. So around 4 years ago, Unreal Engine started supporting HTML5 platform packaging option. There is no extra plugin or any mods need. You can compile and package your project into HTML5 format directly from packaging menu. So my first test, I'm going to use a basic first-person shooting demo from Unreal Engine. It has all the game's basic functionalities like controls, physics, light, and ready to run. So I'm going to package it into HTML5 from the menu. After a couple minutes, here's the output, an HTML file, CSS, and JavaScript. I'm going to use Visual Studio Code to create a local web server and Firefox for browser. The demo runs smoothly without any glitch or lagging at all. And if I turn the full screen mode on, I have no idea this is running on browser. The engine core was compiled into WebAssembly, which allows web browser to run a binary code with similar performance with native application. Then each frame will be painted into web page on canvas HTML element. CPU and GPU usage is relatively low. I was expecting this to run inefficiently, but it seems like I have underestimated the Unreal team. So the next test, I'm going to run a more demanding demo. This project has multiple light sources with high resolution texture and reflection. This time, I will use a Stat.js, a JavaScript library to monitor the frame rate by adding code in the Unreal Engine rendering loop. The result exceeded my expectation. The project is still running smoothly at 60 frames per second at 1080p resolution, and CPU and GPU usage is only around 30-40%. To be honest, it looks just like a scene from a modern game. So let's raise the bar. For the next test, I'm going to use a larger map size, foliage, volumetric light, and screen space reflection. And this is when I start to see limitation. The project runs smoothly, but some of the visual effects are removed when running on browser. You can see the volumetric light and some reflections are missing. Still an impressive scene and good performance though. So I spent around 2 days playing with HTML5 and here's my summary. Unreal Engine performs quite well in web browser. This creates many opportunities for web developers to show their skills and creativities without the platform limitation. However, there are several drawbacks. First is the massive download size that's going to hit the server, typically several hundred megabytes per project. So I think it's only practical for a small game, product, or design demonstration. Also, the engine features are limited. For example, I tried to load a scene with realistic foliage, but turns out the engine couldn't support extremely high detail texture material and reverted to an ugly default texture. Not all the projects can be run on browsers. It needs to be designed to support HTML5 from start. For example, I tried to run an official open world demo from Unreal team, and it stuck at packaging stage for a whole day without any progress, so I decided to abort. And if that's not bad enough, Unreal team decided to remove HTML5 support since version 4.24 and change it to an extension instead. So if anyone wants to export a project in HTML5, they will need to download the Unreal Engine source code from GitHub, then combine it with HTML5 platform extension, then recompile the engine editor. I tried it myself and it's a pain. I'm not really sure what's the reason behind this, but I guess it's about reducing their workload, because now the developer community have to take care of this extension instead. Anyway, if you are not using the latest feature of the engine like ray tracing, you can download the older version of Unreal Engine which natively support HTML5. So that's all for this video, hope you guys enjoy. If you want to see more web development tips and tutorials, subscribe this channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching, see you next time, bye!